Hi, my name is Mauricio, and together with my partners Will, Justin, and Kyle, we're going to tell you about how we experimentally determined Planck's constant. So a brief overview of our experiment is we created a simple LED circuit to be used in conjunction with Vernier hardware, voltage and amperage probes, as well as an emission spectrometer to measure the wavelengths as well as the voltage threshold for six different LEDs ranging from violet to infrared. Materials for this, our circuit materials were a logic board, those six different LEDs that I just mentioned, a 100 ohm resistor, and our variable power supply. And then our Vernier materials were, like I said, an emission spectrometer, a voltage probe, and a current probe as well. And our circuit design is fairly simple, like I said. It comes in here with our 5 volt power supply into our 100 ohm resistor, which is then going in series with our ammeter to our LED, and then again over to ground, and we have our voltage meter measuring the voltage across the entire circuit.
As for our experimental procedure, it is also rather simple. Our first step is to build the LED circuit that Mauricio had just mentioned and do several trials for each LED, switching out the LED each time and recording their frequency of the light that is emitted from the diode, as well as the voltage and the current flowing through it. And we will use that to determine voltage threshold, which Justin will not talk about.
So this is an example of one of the LEDs that we use, specifically the violet LED. As you can see, there's a trend along which all of our LEDs actually followed, where as the voltage increased, it steadily stayed at zero until the current steadily stayed at zero until a certain point where there was a sudden increase exponentially, and then it dropped down. There was a certain point where we had the linear put a linear fit within these trials to find the voltage threshold. So to find the voltage threshold, what we had to do, as I mentioned earlier, was find the most linear part. This specifically is an example from one of our yellow LEDs. So as you can see, from between these two black brackets here, we assume that to be our closest to the most linear part of our graph. At this point, what we can also assume is that where the line of best fit crosses over the voltage potential axis is where the line of best fit is, or is where the voltage threshold is. From there, we can use the examine function on LogerPro to find where the intersection of the line of best fit is with the voltage potential axes. This is where we got our voltage threshold. And Will now explain how we use this voltage threshold data.
So when we compared the frequency of the wavelength to threshold voltage, we found a fairly linear trend between the two. So finding this linear trend, we completed a least squares data analysis where we found the slope of the linear regression to be 4.57 times 10 to the negative 15th joules seconds per coulomb with an error of 1.3 times 10 to the negative 17th of the same units. We determined that this slope is actually our Planck's constant divided by our elementary charge unit, which is 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19th coulombs. So multiplying that should give us our Planck's constant. So we determine our Planck's constant to be 7.33 plus or minus 0.02 times 10 to the negative 34th joules seconds. And now Kyle will talk about error and our conclusion.
All right. So with our sources of error, the main problem that we had is that we did not end up zeroing out the voltage in the beginning or any of the ammeters. So what this caused, this caused us to have a loss in some of our points, and the accuracy was also a loss in translation as a result of this. So for the future, we need to make sure that we zero out our information so everything is as accurate as it can possibly be, and make sure that we get the right values. There was also the problem that a lot of the voltage that we went on is based on a lot of the things that we find with our eyes and what we're looking at on the graph. Now, the best way to really improve this is to use some sort of algorithm where we'd be able to determine the threshold voltage instead of looking at it, because with our eyes, we're not gonna be able to see all of the accurate points that could count as our threshold voltage. And our last source of error was that our voltage increases were very inconsistent. Not very inconsistent, but that it was different between each of the people doing it. We had about two or three people turning the voltage up at different times, so there's different scenarios that could have happened and just different variances that occur between them. And in conclusion, the true value of Planck's constant is 6.626 times 10 to the negative 34th joule seconds. The experimental value is found to be 7.33 plus or minus 0.02 times 10 to the negative 34th joule seconds. Though the value is on the same order of magnitude as the true value, Planck's constant did not fall within the registered value, so while the overall experiment wasn't a complete failure, we obviously learned how to find Planck's constant through these different scenarios that we used. Thank you so much for listening.